questions about property taxes again. And, you know, here's just one example. You know, Monmouth County property taxes up 11% this year alone. My assessment up $40,000 on a two-bedroom house. Towns are not lowering the rates because of the reassessments. And, you know, this is a story that we've heard, you know, over and over and over again, is that, you know, they may be staying under that cap, but when they do a reassessment and increase the values of all of those homes, the property taxes are going up.
Yeah, but Eric, if the value of your home is greater, then that's the way it goes. And you have the right to appeal that. And you can go and have objective people who come in. If you believe that the assessment of your house is too high, you can bring people in. Lawyers do that on a contingent fee basis, based upon, you know, how much money they save you on their property, on your property taxes. They get a piece of that then going forward. So it's not usually a big out-of-pocket expense for folks. And you can go and you can challenge that. But, you know, part of the problem here is that we're not getting enough reassessments done across the state. And what happens is, when you don't, so much gets based upon your property tax base in terms of state aid and other things. It's not fair to the other communities either if you just don't go through a reappraisal or a reassessment. So if, in fact, your home is worth more, then you have to pay taxes based upon the value of your home. That has nothing to do with a property tax cap, which says that the rate can't go up more than 2%. But if the value of your home goes up, then the value of your home has gone up. Now, they're not doing assessments and appraisals every year. They can't do it every year. So
they're limited to how? Is it every 10 years?
I believe it's 10. Well, yeah. Check me on that, but I believe it's 10. And so, you know, I understand. Because here's what happens. Folks sit at home and they say to themselves, well, my bill went up. I don't care why it went up.
It just went up.
It went up, right? There's certain things I can control and certain things I can't. The value of your home is something I can't control. So if the value of your home goes up, that means the economy's doing better in New Jersey and home values are better in New Jersey. And if you think it's an unfair assessment or appraisal, then you need to challenge it in front of the county tax board. You bring a lawyer in. And they're, like I said to you, most lawyers are willing, who do that work, who take it on a contingent fee basis, and they get a piece of what they save you.
Yeah. Why is New Jersey's economy still lagging behind the rest of the country?
First off, I don't believe that. First off, there were new statistics that came out this week that says New Jersey's jobless claims are at a 15-year low. 15-year low. So the fact is that one of the reasons why we haven't done as well as some of the other states is because we're too expensive. And our taxes are too high. And I've been arguing this for 6 years now. And all I get from the legislature is more attempts to increase more taxes. People leave here, and as a result, the economy doesn't do as well because they can't afford to live here and they can't afford to die here. That's a bad combination. And so the legislature does never want to deal with the issue of taxes. They just believe they can continue to raise them and people will continue to pay them. But it's not the truth, and people are leaving. Now, I've held it off. I've held off taxes from going any higher during my term at the state level. But, you know, believe me, if there's a Democratic governor in my seat at the end of my term, put your hands on your wallet, everybody, because they're coming. They're coming because they've been waiting for years. And, you know, the Americans for Tax Reform came out with a report about 2 months ago that said that I've vetoed more tax increases than any governor in American history. Now, it says something about me for vetoing them. It says more about the fact that I couldn't veto any of those things if the legislature didn't send them. That's how crazy liberal this Democratic legislature is. They've given this governor the opportunity to become the number one tax vetoer in American history.
Let's talk to Marvin in Annandale. Marvin, you're on Ask the Governor with Chris Christie. Hello.
Hi. Hello, Governor Christie.
Yes, sir.
This is Marvin from Annandale.